I'm Mr. Shade. This is Mr. Galbraith. Today we're making Hoovervilles.
October 29th, 1929. The great stock market crash of Black Tuesday signaled the beginning of the Great Depression. As banks and businesses closed shortly after, many unfortunate people lost their money, livelihoods, and material possessions, struggling to find food and shelter.
When there was earth to plow, our guns to bear, I was always there.
Many people were forced to set out in search of better conditions. In cities across the country, shanty towns were constructed by the homeless, who refer to these areas as Hoovervilles. In today's lesson, our students will gain insight into what it was like to live in a Hooverville by constructing one of their own.
Ladies and gentlemen, morning class.
Morning, Mr. G.
Everyone know what we're doing today?
Yes.
Today you're actually going to be constructing your own little makeshift shelter. When you start to lose everything, you have to resort to measures where you never thought you'd have to go. For instance, living out of cardboard boxes, surviving off of the trash. It's a really interesting concept that not many of us will ever hopefully experience. Your first part is going to be actually building your shelter. And yes, there are limited supplies. No, you may not go and steal other people's supplies.
Groups were given a worksheet with activities and questions, and then supplied with few materials, including some cardboard, a few feet of tape, and garbage bags. With just these materials, students worked together to create a shanty large enough to provide a living space for everyone in the group. Throughout the day, our classes were able to construct an entire Hooverville using just these supplies.
Are you planning on being stable in there?
What? We're trying.
We're not done yet.
Oh, we should take the
clip. Yeah, in the body.
Y'all got enough room to lay down in there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can yeah, lay there. I can be like, and then she can go.
You got enough shelter from the cold?
Yeah, man.
So what are you going to do tonight when it drops to 32?
We're going to make a fire.
Huddle, make a fire with what?
Sparking rocks.
People really live like this. You see the pictures on that worksheet?
Yeah, that's horrible.
You need to strike at the camera. Be
scared. To make the connection between the Depression and today's recession, we gave students a newspaper article about 10 cities today without telling them what year it was actually written.
So it taught me to work hard in school, graduate high school, go to college, get a degree, and you'll do fine. You do better than the parents' generations. Marshall says, I did all those things for a while. I had the good life, but nowadays that's not reality.
What year do you think that article was written? If you could take a guess.
Do you have time?
1932? That article was written in November of 2009. That's happening right now.
For real?
What you see out here, these are showing up in California, in Florida, New York, Massachusetts, they're all over the country.
Drama kick, let the drama kick die. Let the drama kick, let the drama kick.
From our experience, this lesson was a great way to show students what it would have been like to live through the Great Depression.
Let the drama kick, let the drama kick die.
Doing this project proved to be a great way to help students empathize with those who lived through the Depression and those who still struggle through today's recession. For anything shown in this video, feel free to email me at crs.shade@gmail.com.